Okay, poppy car.
Big John, every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6'6" and weighed 245. Kind of broad at the shoulder, narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John.
Big John, Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Nobody seemed to know where John got home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone. Didn't say much, kind of quiet and shy, but if you spoke at all, he just said hi to Big John. Somebody said he came from New Orleans, where he got into a fight over a Cajun queen. A crashing blow from a huge right hand sent a Louisiana fella to the promised land from Big John. Big Bad John.
Big John.
Then came the day at the bottom of the mine when the timber cracked. The men started crying. Miners were praying and their hearts beat fast. Everybody thought that they'd breathe their last, said John. Through the dust and the smoke of this man-made hell walked a giant of a man and that miners knew well. Grabbed a sagging timber, gave out with a groan. Like a giant oak tree, just stood there alone. Was Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
With all his strength, he gave a mighty shove. Then a miner yelled out, "Hey, there's a light up above." 20 men scrambled from a would-be grave. Now there's only one man left down in the save. Big John. With Jackson Tim as they started back down, then came that rumble way down in the ground. The smoke and the gas belched out of that mine. Everybody knew it was the end of the line for Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John. Now they never reopened that worthless pit. They just placed a marble stand in front of it. These few words were written on this stand. At the bottom of this mine lies a big, big man. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Or 20 foot long.